In this tutorial, we use OPC Expert to provide third-party applications reliable OPC connections. OPC Expert does this by automatically working around communication problems resulting from network setup, DCOM configuration, OPC interoperability issues, connection failures due to computer restarts, OPC server crashes, and even network disconnections. In this video, we connect to an Iconics OPC server. Of course, this represents any OPC server. We also use Kepware OPC Quick Client to represent any third-party application such as HMI, Plant Visualization, Historian, or any custom application. We chose OPC Quick Client because Kepware carefully designed it to show connectivity success and consequences of various failures. We use Kepware OPC Quick Client because it behaves like most OPC client applications. Let's connect a remote OPC server and subscribe to some items. We will use a simulation server from Iconics, which resides on computer 2. Once we establish the connection, create a group. Finally, subscribe to some items. Subscriptions instruct OPC servers to send updates whenever data changes. We're now receiving automatic data updates from the OPC server. To show communication failure, kill Iconics OPC server. The OPC server is no longer running, but OPC Quick Client does not recognize the failure. It even tells us the quality is good. OPC Quick Client will not tell us anything went wrong because it does not monitor OPC connections. So OPC Quick Client still believes it is connected to the OPC server. To receive updates again, I must manually reconnect to the OPC server. Many OPC client applications behave this way when they lose connection due to computer restarts, OPC server crashes, or network disconnections. OPC Expert can help in all these cases using its Mimic functionality. To get an understanding of this feature, start a new copy of OPC Quick Client. When we look at OPC servers on this computer, we cannot find Iconics OPC server. This is because Iconics OPC server resides on computer 2 and not this computer. So we will get OPC Expert to pretend it is the local Iconics OPC server. To set this up, start OPC Expert and browse this computer. Again, notice Iconics OPC server is not installed on this computer. So let's find Iconics OPC server on the remote computer. Now, drag the server from the remote computer and drop it on this computer. OPC Expert shows details of this OPC server. We're looking at an OPC server on computer 2. The connection will be via DCOM and not tunneling, and the server details are here. Click OK and we're done. Iconics OPC server now appears in our local list of OPC servers. This is not really the Iconics OPC server, but is OPC Expert imitating the remote copy of the OPC server? OPC Expert's configuration is complete. The first copy of OPC Quick Client is connected to the OPC server directly and is currently receiving data. Let's connect the second OPC Quick Client via our newly created OPC server. In OPC Quick Client, connect to the local Iconics OPC server. This connection starts OPC Expert's local OPC server, which is connecting to the remote Iconics OPC server. Add a group like we did before. And finally, add some items. Notice the browsing tree is exactly the same as when we made a remote connection. That's all. We are receiving data. We're now receiving data from both the remote and the local connection. So what's the big deal? Consider what happens when the OPC server crashes. I will kill the OPC server just as I did before. Notice the local OPC connection done through OPC Expert is still working, but the remote connection is dead, just like we saw earlier. Why? OPC Expert is constantly monitoring its connection to Iconic's OPC server. When OPC Expert detects a connection failure, it immediately informs the OPC client and takes action to restore the connection. Look, the direct connection is still dead, so I need to reconnect manually. This works even if I restart computer 2. Once again, OPC Expert recognizes the connection died. It immediately tells the OPC client there is a problem and sets the data quality to bad. OPC Expert keeps retrying again and again until it is finally successful. OPC client applications without this intelligence can use OPC Expert to correct the problem. In this tutorial, we used OPC Expert to provide third-party OPC applications reliable OPC connections. We showed two failure cases, but OPC Expert automatically works around many OPC communication problems resulting from network setup, DCOM configuration, OPC interoperability issues, and connection failures due to computer restarts, OPC server crashes, and even network disconnections. If you have a current connection problem, add OPC Expert as an intermediate step between your OPC client and server applications. OPC Expert is easy to use and is a favorite tool in process control and automation. Troubleshooting and diagnosis is free, so download OPC Expert and give it a try yourself.